It gives me again immense pleasure to be with you on this occasion. I'm standing before you as a resource person as well as the representative of KSTA, Karnataka Science and Technology Academy. First of all, kindly forgive me for having not attended the inaugural session. So on that day, there was a KSTA meeting for selecting the Lifelong Achievement Award for the one of the scientists in this country. So anyway, ಒಂದು ಎರಡು ನಿಮಿಷ ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ. ಹಿರಿಯ ಮಗನಾಗಿ ಹುಟ್ಟಬಾರದು, ಕಡೆ ಭಾಷಣಕಾರಾಗಿ ಹುಟ್ಟಬಾರದಂತೆ. ಅನ್ಫಾರ್ಚುನೇಟ್ಲಿ ಎರಡೂ ನಾನೇ ಆಗೇನಿ, ಹಿರಿಯ ಮಗನು ನಾನೇ, ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಭಾಷಣಕಾರ. ಹ್ಯಾಕ್ ವೈ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೆಲ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಚೇರ್ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಮೇಡಮ್ ವಿಶಾಲಾಕ್ಷಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಪ್ರಭುಜಿ, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ವಳ್ಳಾಜಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಕಲೀಗ್ಸ್ ನಾಯಕ್, ಜಗದೀಶ್ ಪ್ರಸಾದ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆರಿ ಯಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎನರ್ಜೆಟಿಕ್ ಫೆಕಲ್ಟಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಮಹಾಗುಂಡಪ್ಪ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಬೌವ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್. ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವಿಟ್ನೆಸ್ ದ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಓಪನ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ದ ಓಪನ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರ್ ಸೀರೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ KSTA. So I have only witnessed Dr. Prabhuji first lecture. I came to know that why I am telling it kade bhashanakaranta. Already almost all the eminent speakers covered almost all the topics. I have to choose whatever left, or I have to touch the same coin with a different face. So in the morning session, Dr. Prabhuji delivered something about green chemistry and also catalyst, and also something about the various aspects covered in that, like molybdenum, which is present in the enzymes, etc. So I would like to, as I said, to touch only the other face of the coin. I will try my level best to so impress you, whether it is left to you which face is almost covered by the well-known scientist from IISc. So dear friends, I would like to talk on nanotechnology and this word coined with environment. Why, how in the field of nanotechnology or the field of nanomaterials, so which are helping to prevent the pollution of the atmosphere. Dr. Prabhuji told in the morning itself, chemistry is the main polluter. I also endorsed the statement, and also Jagdish Prasad also told that. But at the same time, slightly I would like to modify, not only a polluter, it is also a well cleaner. Why I am telling, when you got up in the morning, till you go to bed, we have to depend on chemistry. Start with paste, made from chemistry. Brush you can take, made from chemistry. When you go to breakfast on the dining table, also so many materials like plate including, so made up of chemistry. And if you are a diabetic or something, you have to take that drug, that also made up of chemistry. And everything, when you go to outside function or college or institution, etc., you have to make your face with a chemistry material. So that's why it is also cleaner, what I can say. So at the same time, why I have coined this nanotechnology with the environment, so let us see in the next slide. So pollution of land, water and also atmosphere. So mainly because of the discharging products of especially chemical industries. So they are the main cause for the polluting the atmosphere. And also the use of toxic reactants. So, which also along with the reagents make the situation very worst. And in addition to that, nowadays the pollution reached highest level. So, this is because it makes the beginning of the green chemistry, as morning you have witnessed, delivered by Dr. Prabhuji, and in the middle of 20th century. So, what is this GC? And already you have known, the GC can be defined as, so, benign synthesis. Environmentally benign chemical synthesis, one can say. I will touch only the important points what I have already collected. The synthetic scheme should be designed in such a way that, so it should give a very least pollutant to the atmosphere. And almost all 100% conversion. So in this line, one has to design the scheme. So that means whatever the raw material we have taken, that is 100% conversion in the form of a product, then there is a minimum waste to the atmosphere, either to land or water or air. So that's why this green chemistry is nothing but one of the aspect in the green chemistry is maximum conversion, that is to the 100%. As you have already seen, that is a atom percentage conversion. Like this also, in this one can say that there is a pollution is has already reached highest level. I can quote here the very common example. So earlier our ancestor used to say that there are only three purest things on this earth. Okay? So namely, tender coconut, mother's milk and cow milk. But I can modify this statement. Our ancestor used to say that there were three purest things, but now there are no purest things on this earth. I think you may agree with me. If you take the tender coconut, so I think 5 to 6 years back you might have heard and also you have witnessed in the media and also newspaper that the especially coconut growers of the Tiptur and also Challakere and something area, they have faced a lot of problems, farmers especially. Why? Because at the initial stage, because of the attack of pests and also insects, so they were not getting a yield. At the initial stage only, that fruit is has fallen down. So they have approached the government, and in turn government has make a alternative way, so to assign the work to the experts. They have recommended that there is a some form of a medicine in the form of a injection. They have given to the root of the coconut tree, and finally what was the result? They found a pesticidal residue in the coconut water. The later on again the farmers have faced this problem because nobody ready to purchase the coconut, tender coconut. Why? Because of the residual of pesticide. So that's why I can say that it is also not a purest thing on this earth nowadays. But our ancestor used to say that it is a purest thing. But if you come to the cow milk or buffalo milk, so you can say, nowadays to get the more margin, the who is selling the milk to the customer, so they used to give a steroid injection, especially oxytocin. So because to get a more yield, so that also appear in the milk as a residue. So that's also not a purest thing. When you come to with due regards, madam, so mother's milk also, because of adulterated food. So when the vegetable came into market without washing, the pesticides which you have already sprayed to get a more yield, so that will come to market without washing, and that will so eaten by the family members, especially mother. So the children who have got a birth from that mother who has eaten that food also found that there is a pesticidal residue in that blood. So that's why mother's milk also is not a so purest as far as my knowledge is concerned. So with due regard, so one can say that the name of nanotechnology came into effect with the idea that there is a plenty of room at the bottom. This statement given by one of the person, Feynman, Richard Feynman, in the year 1959 at the physical, that is American Physical Society, which was held in the year, so 1959. So during that Feynman also he has described what do you mean by nanotechnology. Later on it is the one of the scientist from Tokyo Science University, he also explained in the year 1974 in his research paper, he said that nanotechnology was the work of changing materials by one atom or one molecule. But in the subsequent years, this nanotechnology, according to their convenience, they have described. So afterwards, what is this nano? Nano is nothing but the 1 billionth of a meter. You can compare the nanometer with the meter. That is the billionth of a 1 meter. So if that is the case, this nanotechnology refers to science and technology. So no doubt, at the nano scale of atoms are molecules, and to the scientific principles and new properties that can be understood out of nanomaterial instead of a macro size of material. So why I am describing this, you will come to know. If it is a macromolecule, what are its applications? And if it is in a micromolecule, so what are its applications? So later on you will come to know in the further slides. Okay, so newly emerging technologies in the field of nanoscience and also nanotechnology is gaining a momentum, especially in the 21st century. Expansion, research and development also happening in this field, nanotechnology. And you can see in the next slide, nano begins with the introduction of nanometer, as already I said, which is organizing the matter in a nanometer scale, which has created a revolution in the field of science and technology. How? You will come to know after witnessing the applications. So nowadays the field of catalysis is strongly depend upon the nanomaterials, as I said already, Prabhuji said, but he has covered so homogeneous and heterogeneous out of the organic materials and organic catalyst, etc. But here I would like to stress upon the conventional catalyst, how they act, and the catalyst which comprising the nanomaterials, how they act. So that difference I would like to say. But anything, the conventional catalyst, but our aim is to have a green chemistry. Green chemistry is nothing but we should give a least waste product to the atmosphere, so that we can prevent the atmosphere from pollution. So when conventional catalyst converting the raw material to the product, only 50% or 60% or 80%. So if you replace this conventional catalyst by the nanomaterial based catalyst, so you can go for the 100% conversion. So it will fulfill the aim and objective of the green chemistry. So that's why I take in the 21st century the term, the specific, that is 100% selectivity, is playing an important role in almost all the catalytic chemical processes. Especially disposal of waste is very complex and also very quite expensive. You might have already read, especially for Bangalore solid waste material. So that management is very difficult. So under the circumstances, this is the prime base for the green chemistry. So that is nanotechnology. The above job will be performed by the catalyst designed in such a way that the catalyst impregnated with the nanomaterials, then you will have those applications. So as Prabhu said also, molybdenum is one of the inorganic element which is present in the enzymes. That is nature's catalyst, as I say. So enzymes are nature's catalyst, and majority of them are composed of inorganic nanomaterials which are summarized by high molecular weight proteins. If that is the case, what about homo and heterogeneous catalysts? And so there is a conversion of raw material to product to such an extent that there is not a 100% selectivity and 100% conversion is not possible. So that's where one can shift from conventional catalysts to the nanomaterials like homo and heterogeneous. But when we have to talk about the nanomaterials, what will be the size? Which size will have a more effect? So here you can concentrate on when the particle size is decreased below 100 nm. As I said, 1 nm is nothing but 1 billionth of a meter. So if that is the case, so under such circumstances, the nanomaterials having the particle size 100 nm and below 100 nm, what will happen? Density of defects will be increased. You know, the prime base for the catalyst is the defects should be increased. That is, then only they are going to act as a active sites. Those defects, in nanoparticle material, in a nano size will be very much increased as compared with the conventional catalyst. So that's why, which will have a more applications in the field of catalysis also. When the rate of reaction increase, the job of the catalyst is to increase the rate of reaction. So in turn, when increase the rate of the reaction, raw material to product will be conversion will be more. So then there is a least pollutant to the atmosphere. So that's why nanotechnology is helping in preventing the pollution of the atmosphere in such a way that through the catalyst. The numerous advantages are also one can expect when switching over from conventional to nanomaterial based catalysis. Here one can say that nanoscience is profitably applied to the field of or improvement of the catalysis and the development of new generation and also the catalyst technologies. So there is a global effort to replace the conventional catalyst by the nano-based catalyst. So if that is the case, on the other hand, at one stage one can say that polyaniline salts are also eco-friendly. These polyaniline catalysts are also going to act as a catalyst. So under such circumstances, one can have the help of these along with the polyaniline in a nano scale. Under such circumstances, the nanomaterials can say that they are the fascinating material. So if that is the case, one can go for the most fascinating materials of the day are nanomaterials. These can be defined in the terms of definition. These materials are three-dimensionally modulated, so synthetic materials with the average range size. If that is the case, nanomaterials will exist in three forms or four forms. If it is in the form of a crystallite, so under such circumstances, there is a three-dimensional structure. If it is in the form of a filament, so it is two-dimensional structure. If it is in the form of a layers means you can compare with the sandwich. There is in between a two pieces of bread, so you can put a vegetable. Or they like that the biscuits between the two layers of biscuits top and bottom, and there is a cream. So like that, under such circumstances layers will have only one dimension. And also the last one is there is a cluster, there is a zero dimension. So this nano size range is 1 to 100 nm having particles will have more applications, and especially 0 to 50 nanometer, which is going to act as a vital role in the field of medicine and especially in the field of catalysis, sensor, biomedical, aerosol, filter, and all of these applications will have in the almost in the flag end of this lecture. So important idea one can have about the nanometer. As I already said, 1 nanometer is 1 billionth of a meter. When that is the case, I can compare here the nanometer in the form of a very natural processes. Like you can say the carbon-carbon bond in any molecule, so it may be a distance is 0.122, 0.15. So if that is the case, DNA double helix you can compare, which is about 2 nanometer from one side to the other side of DNA. And also you can compare this one, I can give here the very good example is to understand the scale of nanometer. So the difference between nanometer and meter, one can give the example that between a golf ball and a world. So that much of difference. So between a golf ball and the earth, you can say, so the size between golf ball and earth, what is size difference, and you can compare with the meter and nanometer. And that can be very much very good example is your nail or our nail, you can say, grow 1 nanometer per second. Our nails are grow with 1 nanometer per second. So that much of size one can have. So here there are two common approaches in the field of nanotechnology. One is called as a bottom-up. Another one is called a top down. So what it means,
bottom up means from micro scale to macro scale. Top down process is from macro to micro. So this can also be have with the knowledge that one is a physics room and another one is a chemist room. That we will have in the next slide. So what do we mean by top down process? As I say, that is the macro size to micro size. There is a quantum size effect. Why I am telling here is macro size molecule will have no application as compared with the micro scale. The same thing, I can quote a gold here in the next slide. So here, that means when the particle size come down lesser and lesser, which will have a more physical property, either optical property or electric property or any other property, there is a change in the physical property when you go from macro to micro scale. Here one can example, increase the amount of surface area of the hole inside, so we will have that one. And in the next slide you will have, I can take a material such as gold. You know very well, which does not react with any other chemicals at a normal conditions. Only it will dissolve in aqua regia, Rajas Drava. Okay? So it cannot react very easily. When you cut down to the micro scale, which will have a beautiful applications as a nanomaterial. So this is the very good example for the nanomaterial side. Another process, as I say, bottom up, from micro scale to macro scale. So that can also be having with the very good examples. Okay? Such techniques can also be so differentiated between the several synthetic routes. Here there are two routes. One is by breaking the larger particle to smaller, that is macro to micro scale. And the second one is by employing so nucleation and growth. From a small particle to you can grow the crystal, just like a you can grow a crystal. These are the two processes can be defined under the banner of, one is called a chemist route, that is called as a building up process. Another one is called a physicist route, that is so physical route, breaking down process. In chemist route, I will concentrate only on solution combustion synthesis. This is only the important route for the preparation of nanomaterial. Okay, when we are talking about only chemistry, we can have. Here is a combustion or a fire synthesis of nanomaterial. Everyone will talk about the applications of nanomaterials. And our aim is to how to synthesize these nanomaterials and what are its applications. How can you determine the size of the nanomaterial? That is most important. So here you can have, what is fire? Fire is a uncontrolled combustion. Suppose if fire catches, then you go to control a particular temperature. It's not possible. You cannot stop at a particular temperature, the desired temperature. So that's where fire is nothing but a uncontrolled combustion. And what is combustion? Combustion is an exothermic reaction, so which accompanied with the evolution of heat and light. So this can be exemplified or schematically one can represent. So there is a triangle, the fuel one side along with the oxidizer. So you will be having a fire with a high temperature and accompanied by heat and light. So what will be the net result of this? So you will be ended with the ash. So I can compare this one with any amongst you from a village. Okay, still today in villages, the solid fuel is used for cooking. There are three fuels, you know. One is gaseous fuel, which is used in the cities, LPG gas. Another one is a solid fuel, wood used for the cooking. And one more, liquid fuel. Okay, so amongst these solid fuel, so in villages, I have seen and also you might have seen. So after cooking, the burnt wood will become in the form of a ash. Okay, so that ash is now also using for the cleaning purpose of the utensils. Instead of using a vim powder or some cleaning agent, villagers are doing. Why? So they are very much clean as compared with the artificial cleaner. Why it is happened? So why I am stressing this point is, the ash one can have idea that ash containing a very beautiful novel property. So that's why that the action of cleaning, so of a wood when it is burnt in the form of ash is used for the cleaning purpose. So they are having a so very novel properties. So in the next slide, so combustion synthesis is also known as fire synthesis or the furnaceless synthesis. You need not required any furnace for this purpose. Automatically it will catches fire, it will be ended with a material, that material in the form of a nano material, that is a nanoscale. So that is also known as self-propagating high temperature synthesis. So that is in short one will call as a SHS. Okay, other SHS processes are solid state material and single source precursor, glycine nitrate process and flame synthesis. But here if you look into the history, so how they have ended with a very novel properties material. Here you can take the example in the year 1825, Berzelius, he has heated the zirconium metal, so and ended with zirconium oxide. So nano materials normally in the form of oxides, or as is also in the form of oxides. So like motion, he has heated the titanium in presence of nitrogen and ended with titanium nitride. And like that, there are so many examples in the history, like Goldsmith. So here he has taken the iron oxide in presence of aluminium metal and heated at high temperature, ended with aluminium oxide. That oxide is also having a novel property. So my interest is to say that almost all the ash material in the form of an oxide, those are in a nanoscale and having a very high novel property. And if you come to the combustion also covers, there are two processes. One is called smoldering, that is called as a solid gas. Another one is a flaming. Solid gas process is below 1000 degree and the second one is the above 1000 degree centigrade will be taken place. And here redox mixture, oxidizer are important to get a solution combustion process. And here one can use the fuels are nothing but urea, carbohydrate and so many things, and you will get the same thing I can show here in the schematic diagram. On one side oxidizer, oxidizer usually metal nitrate. On the other side fuel, fuel usually hydrazides or urea. So we have taken the example in the next slide, aluminium nitrate and also urea, and how it will get the oxide form you will come to know. By taking the, these two mixture, fuel and oxidizer in presence of aqueous redox mixture and at 500 degree centigrade, you will get a foam. Okay, that foam in the form of a catches a fire and will be ended with a combustion residue in the form of a ash. This process is called SCS method or solution combustion synthesis. So here you will have a video diagram, you will have that one. The same I say, the redox mixture is metal nitrate, that is aluminium nitrate, and the urea is going to act as a fuel, and at 500 degree centigrade, how will we end it this one? A file you there? One file then or video file. You see, the same aluminium nitrate and also urea, the mix that one in presence of aqueous media reduction. So will be ended with a fine ash material. Just like a Nagar Panchami Gola Arrow in the Puttala. And like that, one can say that chemistry comes alive. There are so many experiments that video files I will show you, but it's not connected with this present talk. You can have here, there is a liquid solid gas, bromine. Automatically they will catch the fire, need not any external agent is there. You can go to next video.
because time is short. I have given only 1 hour allotted. Here is a fire without matchstick. You can see. Take the two materials, KMnO4 and another thing, and it will gas automatically. And if you go to next ignition, you can go to iodine. And you go to last volcano. You cannot artificial volcano. So you have to take that one. Potassium, the ammonium dichromate, and also something. So how the volcano experiment one can have this. All everything ended with the ash material, with a very particle size are very less. And these are the simple experiments to have the idea about that. You go to the earlier. Okay. You can enlarge. Thank you. So in the next slide, so we will have the methods to determine the particle size. So we have an idea about the synthesis and how can we determine the size of the particle. There are two ways before you. The one is direct method, that is called as a TEM method. So that is called as a transmission electron microscopy. You will have the direct size. Or indirect method is this, by using the X-ray and neutron cells. There is a neutron scattering, and there is a formula according to this one can have the size of this, so particle. Now, combustion synthesis, what is one form? We have seen the various oxide form. So like that here, you can take the carbides. So when carbon is mixed with either titanium or silica, you will be ended with a titanium carbide or silicon carbide. And those are having a very good examples and applications used as abrasives, cutting tools, and also ceramic reinforcement. Like that borax, boron with the titanium and other elements, so like silicon ended with the borax and silicide. We have a various application in the form of the nanomaterial. And in the next, here is a, on left hand side you can have a nanomaterial and right hand side application, and there are very good applications in the industry. And the some features of solution combustion synthesis. Just you have seen the video diagrams or the picture, video experiments, live experiments, and how this combustion synthesis will be very useful. And when you go downer and downer, or lesser and lesser sizes of like titanium dioxide or aluminium oxide in the form of those, that will be very vital. Then I will come to this part, which is already so taken in our laboratory. There is a per-evaporation or gas separation. So the membranes also having a vital role. So that means for separation of gas to gas mixture or liquid gas mixture, and also between liquid liquid mixture. So this will have a vital role in especially industrial processes, industrial separation. So what we mean by the separation, the basis of the separation is the rate of transport. How liquid will move from, that is the one phase to another phase through the membrane. And the rate is governed by how much gets into the membrane and how much passes and how much it moves from that, depending upon two processes, one is solubility and another one is diffusivity. So under the circumstances, so here is a per evaporation process, and designed this experiment in the laboratory, in our own laboratory, and here the feed, whatever separation liquid is loaded at the top, and membrane, there is a green color, this is the membrane, and which is pressing and passing through that one, and the separation between two liquids. And why I am telling here is, per evaporation means separation between the liquid-liquid or gaseous mixture, so with the help of the membrane. And we have filtered through the media of filter paper, then separation is possible. And like that here, there are so many membranes are available for the separation. But here we have taken the eco-friendly polymer. Okay? That polymer is the synthesized with the help of the raw material which are eco-friendly. So why I am telling here, the polymers are impregnated with 13 nanomaterials. Those are having a very good properties as compared to the macro size polymer. So if that is the case, So this is another gas separation process which is also designed in our laboratory. And the next is membrane forming material. On one side inorganic material, on other side inorganic, so impregnated or composed with the organic. So here the glasses and polycellulose, ceramics, there is iron containing polymers like that, so many things. So if you come to the next, what are the advantages of membrane separation? So the separation between the conventional process and also the membrane methods which are eco-friendly. That is, our aim is to the prevent the pollution of the atmosphere. If you go for the separation with the help of conventional process, the energy intensive. But on the other hand, we can conserve the energy. On the left hand side, high capital cost in case of conventional separation, and if you use the membrane method, there is a low capital cost. And last space required for the electron and less space for the membrane. And control and maintenance, and here easy to operate and maintain. And highly hazardous conventional process and very safe of the polymerization. And which is unclean, the laboratory will become very wet and everything. But here environmental clean. So here again we will have a more applications of the nanoparticles, especially in drug derivatives. Here I can give the example that is called as a blood-brain barrier. You will have the slide in the next picture, but you can have idea about this. Nanoparticles are solid colloidal particles. Okay? These are consisting of various macromolecules in which therapeutic drugs can be absorbed. Absorption you know very well. Drug can be absorbed on the polymer or a nanoparticle, or it can be entrapped, or it can be covalently attached to the nanoparticle. If there are three processes, one is absorption, or it can be covalently attached, or it can be, so again, entrapped the, that one. Which will have a more application in the field of medicine, later on we will come to know. One utility of this nanoparticle is to serve as a novel drug delivery carriers to tissues throughout the body. In recent years, biodegradable polymeric nanoparticles have gained considerable attention, especially in this field, as a drug delivery or a drug carrier. So here the methods of preparation of nanoparticle by the way of conservation method. So here what we did, the drug molecule can be impregnated with a polymer which is eco-friendly. So especially this will be more useful for the patient who is suffering from diabetic. Okay, what happened nowadays, if the diabetic patient taken the tablet one time, okay, if it is not a polymeric based, there is a layer by layer, so when you swallow the tablet, so within an hour drug will be released to the body, sugar content will be going to lower. Okay. But yet in this case, why I am telling you a conservation method, drug is impregnated with the polymer. So if it is a manufactured, the drug impregnated with polymer, when you swallow the tablet, first layer is going to dissolve. Okay, when the first layer of polymer dissolve, particular concentration of drug will be released to the body. And when next layer is going to dissolve, and again the particular concentration of drug will be released to the body. Like that, the 24 hours the supply of drug, so in the way of this impregnated polymer or a nanoparticle drug delivery. So these also one can say supercritical anti-solvent method one can have an impregnated drug. And in the other method, anion polymerization for production of nanoparticles. So here solvent evaporation method. And this is the important one, as I said. You can see there are two figures here. One is green drug and another one is impregnated with nanoparticles. Okay? Here we can see this is the barrier. Okay? As I said, blood-brain barrier. Here what happens, this blood-brain barrier, so the drug will be delivered, and because of the compact cell in the brain, the drug molecule having a macro size cannot be entrapped into the layer of the brain, and you can see the concentration of the drug, free drug is as remains, only few particles have been passed. But if the drug is impregnated with nanoparticle in the nano size, So the concentration, almost all the drug molecules are being entrapped into the blood-brain barrier. So the required concentration will be supplied to the brain, and like that, these nanoparticles are called as a polysorbate coating nanoparticle. And here also one can give the example. This is an ordinary one. So when the person swallows the tablet for any common flu or common cold or etc. or a fever, so what happens in this? The pH of the body of person to person differs. You know very well. One, some persons will suffering from acidity. Okay? When such a case, the journey of the tablet starts from mouth to gastrointestine. Okay? When its journey starts from mouth, so depending upon the pH of the body, so in some cases the drug is going to dissolve at the first stage only, or after passing the few centimeters, or you can say in size. So then when it reaches the destination where exactly drug is going to act, at that time the required concentration will not be or retained, you can say. So that's why nowadays what happens, you can see earlier tablets, I think you might have not seen. If you take the tablet into the hand, so if you press it, it will be there itself is going to break. But nowadays it is polysorbate coated. If you take the tablet between the two fingers, it will escape from your finger. So why it is? So because that layer should not dissolve, even though pH of the body is high. When it reaches the target point, there only it is going to dissolve and the drug concentration will be supplied, required concentration. So that is the idea of the tablet. So this is the one figure who says about that one. Okay. Next, nanotechnology application. I will come into this. So because which has have a very wide applications, especially first field is space. This nanotechnology may hold the key to making a space flight more practical. So advancement in nanomaterials make lightweight spacecraft. Not only this, you can take very ordinary. If you might have seen the bogies of trains, earlier trains, these are made up of a metal only, heavy bogies. Nowadays you can see, if you go to the bathroom in that compartment, those are made up of a polymeric base. Okay? If you take the space aircraft, also they have become very lighter. So just like in place of the aluminium metal or any other metal, polymer materials have been placed there. So when the become a very light, it gets a speed, and when it gets a speed, the mileage will be more. So whenever you go to buy a four-wheeler or a two-wheeler also, various parts are made up of polymer instead of a metal. Because to become a lightweight, you will get a mileage more. Okay? So that's the idea. When you see the earlier ambassador craft, this mudguard, the front one, usually made up of a metal on the layer. When you hit the person, definitely, so it's end. But now, there is a rule, government make a rule that those mudguards would be made up of only polymeric material, not from the metal. That is the idea about that, okay? So, not only spacecraft and also nowadays various the vehicles on the earth are made up of. And in the field of electronics also, nanotechnology having a more application, increase the capability of electronic devices. And in food industry, is having an impact on several aspects of food science. Again, it will be one can quote here, CFTR, Central Food Research Institute at Mysore, you can see. The research and development is having such a day. If you go to any field, we will have a this much of food. But nowadays, especially the research is going on food material in the form of the capsules. If any army in the field during the war, either civilian war or something, so if you take the one capsule, you can spend life for a day. That much of calorie. So such a research is also going on. And fuel cells also, so here nanotechnology being used to reduce the cost of the catalyst used in fuel cells to produce hydrogen ions from fuels such as methanol and chemical vehicles. And like that, there are so many solar cells also, and in batteries also having a role, and in fuels, and the better air quality also, such as cleaner water, chemicals and so on. 14 boots. In 14 boots also, we can take earlier that the settlement are bags. Such a bags are made up of metals. So it is heavy to move. Such a material as replaced by the camel material. And also support the news and incident to the cafe. Okay, these are the medicinal trade and information technology, energy production and storage, material science, instrumentation, etc. And lastly, biomedical applications. So these can be obtained by thermal denaturation of proteins. Okay, characterization of the sterically stabilized nanospheres allows the establishment of parameters like there was the immunobehavior also. Chemical composition and polymeric particulate nanocarriers also, as I said, blood-brain barrier, able to deliver the drugs to the particular spot, that is in the form of a nanoparticle brain. The mechanism of drug transport from nanoparticles to blood-brain barrier, as you see, that is a, due to the binding of nanoparticles to the inner endothelial layer of the brain capillary. So here drug brain barrier providing a large concentration gradient we are seeing here. And also here, as I said, nanoparticle having the size lesser than 20 nm are being used for the blood brain barrier. Not only that, so other drugs are also injectable. So if you give a injection, you need not use the injection your ears put together. Such a material so impregnated with the nanoparticles also. Sometimes up to 1 year you cannot take the injection. Such a applications also in the field. And various way, and I will come to the last slide as the time is very short, 4 hours already. They have asked me to complete my 4. Another fascinating thing is that nanostructured lipid carriers, those are in short called as the NLCs. These are now introduced in the field of cosmetics, which is used by you only. Okay? How you can say? One of the companies by name Dr. Rimbler, Nano World, he has introduced into the market, there are 3 gel-based nano repairs. So, under them, one is cream nano repair under the brand name Q10. So, this nano repair, Q10 is called as an anti-aging product. Okay? This nano cream available in the market, if you use this cream, so 40 years man will look like a 20 years. Like a 30 years woman will look like 18 years. So such a, because that cells are going to stimulate the body's skin, okay, because of the nano size. As I said, ash is not a useless. Ash containing a novel property, as I have given a solid fuel, wood, burn fruit is giving a gas. The gas is used for the cleaning purpose, as I said. Like that here, there are in a cream nano repair anti-aging product, supply energy to the skin cells and also stimulate body natural functions of against the oxidative stress, even sunlight, sunburn that can be controlled because of the nano repair. Okay, in the next slide and the last one. This is called as a serum nano repair. Q10 is the supplement came in the product line. And it was developed especially for the facial expression area. Okay? So this figure tells us, and these are the trainings and etc. The future is not tomorrow, the future is now. Okay? And with this one can have another area that, so you know, I think you might have heard about chili. Red chili, especially from Bali, near by Dharwa, which is very famous on chili, which is exporting. Why? They are extracting the red color, which is going to use in the preparation of lipstick. So that's also very interesting one. That is a food technology. Okay? So thank you. So this lecture.